We think a lot about the promise that we make to parents and to students as they're thinking about where to come to school. One of the things that I think we need to be absolutely sure of when we bring a student here is that they all get a great experience at Andover. How do we honor that promise so that every child comes out of Andover thinking, wow, I got a great shot at this amazing education? One of the things that I'm most excited about at Andover right now is the way in which we are reimagining what excellence can be. Andover has a traditional approach to education that is very, very strong, and there are many ways in which we will continue to build upon that strength. But I also think that we need to prepare kids for a very different world than our parents and our grandparents experienced.
Content is no longer the end game of a course description. It's the skills that you get and how we excite students and train them to be able to ask any question they want and to become an expert whenever they need to.
My project has to do with bipolar disorder and neurodegenerative diseases.
And so our kids join this professional community of scientists that are working around the globe on similar types of questions.
I was looking online at different studies where they had used a plasmid so that I could borrow it from somebody else. There was this guy who worked in Japan at a university, and I just reached out to him through email. It became an incredible partnership.
The world that these kids are going into is really project-based. The internet, globalization, and this project-based idea are actually the strongest arguments in favor of the liberal arts model. We need to teach our kids how to learn on their own. Our students come from all over the world, from all walks of life. They're coming into a community which is probably the most diverse that they've ever been in. While they're here, we need to be good at creating a community that allows them to be their best. Financial aid is part of it. Let's find the greatest community of students to come here. Let's not have financial capacity be a barrier.
Being from Lawrence, even though the trip is literally 15 minutes from my garage to my doormat, Andover, it feels like I'm worlds apart. In every way you can think of, everything is different.
We've had a long history of youth from every quarter. What we've learned, however, is that just by being a diverse community does not automatically give all students equal access. What we would like to do is to make sure that our students' backgrounds do not create a lack of equity when they're here. And that is our challenge right now.
It can be difficult at times when the person who lives next door to you, for example, is from a different country. Sometimes there are cultural issues, but you learn to work it out. Because it's a residential community, an intentional community, you really have to learn to work together. And I think in the end, I'm all the better for it.
Thinking about myself now, 17 years old, starting my senior year, I'm completely different than the 14-year-olds who started at Andover.
Andover has a long tradition of thinking about education more broadly. That is absolutely the frame for the Institute, which is how can this community focus on these wonderful discussions that are going on at a national and international level about the future of education?
Education in the United States has not changed in more than 200 years. There are certain times that there are opportunities for seismic shifts to happen. We're in that moment in education.
The Tang Institute is a research institute, a lab of sorts, a central hub for creative ideas driven by faculty and other community members.
The invitation from the Institute, and certainly my invitation to the faculty, is to say, let's innovate together. Let's find the way in which we can make the dreams that you've had for a long time come true.
Creating the calculus curriculum for Khan Academy is a great example of the values and modes that the Institute can support.
We create content that we've had our kids do for years, and we put it out there nationally on the Khan Academy site. 2 months later, 12,000 different users have had an opportunity to do the problem, and you can see how many people are getting it right. It really is going to change the way you teach.
The Institute is a way for us to support really important projects that we think then will influence what's going on here on campus and also share with colleagues in other schools.
Currently, the maps are used in history classes, English classes, art classes, and math classes.
We have all these ways in which we're integrating the Knopfel map collection to our classrooms, but we're also digitizing them and making them available to as many people as possible. That bi-directional exchange and learning is an incredible part of what Andover can do.
What I tell students is, if you are moved by an issue, there are ways to approach learning about this issue from multiple perspectives, to approach it with a sense of humility, and then to marry goodness and knowledge into action.
The idea is not that we go there and we want to help the world. The idea is that we go out there and we learn from the world. We're hoping to connect what they did during their program back to what we all do on campus.
Niswarath is about starting to grapple with big issues and starting to look at how individual stories play into this. What I have most taken away from the program has been the connections that I've made both with Andover students and with the people we met there.
The kind of life that we wish for an Andover student does include a certain degree of contemplation.
We are going to have to look far more holistically at the lives of our students and how that intersects with the curriculum.
We are about to have a building, the Rebecca M. Sykes Wellness Center, that will incorporate the counseling services as well as the traditional medical services and have an area for health education. In order for one to perform at their peak potential, they have to be healthy. What I try to get students to do is to step back and enjoy the journey. It's about really enjoying the entire process of Phillips Academy.
I think that we can intentionally design a program that brings out the best in students and at the same time maintains a level of balance and well-being.
One of the great privileges of my job as head of school and the job of every member of the faculty and staff is that we are focused on a set of ideals that are timeless. And we're absolutely in a position to provide an education to students where they get knowledge with goodness out of their experience at Andover for this new century.